Generative artificial intelligence expected to shape next year's workforce. That's according to job platform LinkedIn, which marked 1 billion members by sharing insights into workplace trends in 2024. LinkedIn found 55% of the Philippine workforce already used Gen AI. It added the need for soft skills has become more pronounced as AI automates more tasks. Over 70% of local professionals now place more importance in skills such as problem solving, creativity, and communication. LinkedIn also noted that 55% of Filipinos believe AI will facilitate a more diverse and inclusive workforce. In particular, members of Gen Z think investing in AI is crucial to attracting and retaining the future of Philippine workplaces.
More Philippine companies are committing to the country's sustainability agenda through various policies and programs. Willard Chang tells us more about them in this report.
Officials of some of the top companies in the Philippines gathered for the second Sustainability Forum, organized by the Manila Bulletin, aimed at raising awareness on the importance of sustainability and protecting the environment.
Hopefully, showcase of basically how it has to be collaborative sustainability, that it can't be just a unilateral approach by one company saying, hey, I'm going to be sustainable. For us to be effective, we all have to work hand in hand together.
Mega World Hotels and Resorts has included sustainability in its corporate culture by practicing optimum land use, reduced carbon footprint, effective waste management, and responsible consumption. Under its Me Green program and Project Sampaguita, the company has helped boost the livelihood of Sampaguita garland makers and vendors in the Sampaguita industry with the use of the national flower in its products.
Having to touch base with everyone whose lives are hinged on the Sampaguita industry is more than enough inspiration for us to make sure that this gets to become an advocacy.
IKEA Philippines sells affordable and sustainable products made from renewable and recycled materials and is offering more plant-based meals in its restaurants.
People are looking for solutions and responsible brands. And we believe that our customers are looking for sustainable products and services. And shopping more mindfully and looking at companies more critical than ever. They are looking for brands with a purpose.
Ascot Properties has intensified efforts in low carbon transition, water conservation and resilience, sustainable accommodations, waste management and circular economy solutions with its green properties, and increasing electricity consumption from renewable sources, among others.
Look at it from a corporate standpoint. A lot of corporate companies are asking specifically about your sustainable practices, and that becomes a forte in terms of whether they're going to book with you.
SM Prime has undertaken sustainable steps to protect the environment by using alternative energy measures and efficient water supply in its sites. It also supports communities affected by climate risks.
SM Marikina was then built on stilts that served as water retention tanks so that when it does flood, water can be held and protect in the site, protecting not only the malls and the customers, but the larger community. We've also installed weather stations in a large number of our malls, which provide accurate and localized meteorological weather notifications for the residents around and for the community around to help them prepare better for their day.
The DENR stressed the importance of sustainability, with the Philippines remaining as a top country with the highest disaster risk, and with countries still far from reaching the global net zero goal and sustainable development goals.
It underscores the need for accelerated and collective efforts on a global scale. Addressing this urgent issue requires a whole of government and a whole of society approach.
Willard Cheng, ABS-CBN News.